Assalamu alaikum. Here is part third of tenses. Today we will try to learn about perfect or complete tense. Perfect tense is also known as complete tense. There is a reason behind it, because it describes the completion of action. We use third form of verb. Perfect tense is used to express actions which have completed their sense. Starting from present perfect tense, if we have to make positive, or we can say affirmative sentence, we will use subject plus has, have plus V3, third form of verb. Subject, you know, actor or doer of an action. Then we have two auxiliary verbs, has or have. We have to make sure to follow the concord here. With singular subjects, we use has. With plural subjects, we will use have plus V3, third form of verb. For example, if I write, she has cooked food. She is a singular subject, that's why we use it has. If the subject is plural, they have finished the job. Okay, coming to third example, you know, we consider I as plural subject, so we will use I have written a letter. Okay, let us make it negative sentence. If we have to make a negative perfect tense, we will introduce simply not. It will be subject plus has, have plus not plus V3, third form of verb. She hasn't cooked food. If we have to change this into negative, we will write they haven't finished their job. I have written a letter. Its negative will be I haven't written a letter. Okay. Well, making a positive interrogative sentence, we will do the same process. We will extract helping verbs out. It is have, has, plus subject, plus V3, third form of verb. It will become, has she cooked food? Has she cooked food? Note of interrogation. Have they finished their job? Have I written a letter? Negative interrogative. You know, we introduce not into negative interrogative. We will write it like this: has, have plus not plus subject plus V3. Hasn't she cooked food? Hasn't she cooked food? Haven't they finished their job? Haven't I written a letter? Okay. Let us come to its past form, past perfect. Past perfect is made. We will do a simple thing here, like we did in continuous tense. We will change the forms of helping verbs. Has, have will be changed into had. Subject plus had plus V3 third form of verb. She has cooked food will be changed into she had cooked food. This indicates the action of the past that has finished. They had finished their job. I had written a letter. Okay. It's negative. Will be like Sam, we did have subject plus had plus not plus V3 third form of verb. She had not cooked food. They hadn't finished their job. I hadn't written a letter. Okay. Negative, sorry, positive interrogative. Has and have will be changed into had. It will be followed by subject V3. Had she cooked food? Had she cooked food? Had they finished their job? Had I written a letter? Had I written a letter? Okay. Negative interrogative. The same procedure will be followed. Had plus not plus subject plus V3. Hadn't she cooked food? Hadn't she cooked food? Hadn't they finished job, their job? Hadn't I written a letter? Okay. Future perfect. Future perfect is used when we talk about a future action. When we assume a future action to be finished, we will use subject plus will, shall, plus have, plus V3. There is no concord, so we choose actual verb, that's have. Has it, its singular form. It will be made like this. She will have cooked food. They will have finished their job. I shall have written a letter. Okay. Negative form will be made by subject plus will, shall, plus not, plus have, plus V3, third form of verb. She will, she won't, she will not have cooked food. They won't, they will not have finished the job, their job. I shall not have written a letter. Okay. Interrogation. Future interrogation. Will, shall, plus subject, plus have, plus V3. Will she have? Will she have cooked food? Will they have finished their job? Will they have finished their job? Shall I have written a letter? Shall I have written a letter? Negative interrogative. Will shall plus not plus subject plus have plus V3. It will be won't she have cooked food? Won't, will not, they have finished their job? Shall not, shan't, I have written a letter. Okay. This is our third tense, that is perfect tense or complete tense. Its last part is remaining, and in the next lecture, inshallah, we will complete our tenses. Till then, stay tuned, focus on your studies. Inshallah, I will be back.